Today we're going to be taking apart the OnePlus 3, the new flagship killer from the company OnePlus. Luckily the phone is not that hard to take apart. Let's get started. First thing we're going to do is remove the dual SIM card tray from the side. And then there are two screws along the bottom of the phone, similar to how an iPhone works, except for these are a T2 screw. I will link all of the tools and replacement parts that you need down in the video description. I found it was easiest to start on the side of the phone. If you remember during my durability video, the screen popped out of the frame just a little bit along that center line. So I put my metal pry tool between the edge of the screen and the edge of the frame and then pried up a little bit, and switched to my plastic tool as soon as possible, because metal on metal doesn't work out so well for electronics. The screen lifted out relatively easily once it was up, and here is the single slab of aluminum that OnePlus talked about. You can see the mill lines on the bottom, so they weren't joking around when they said it was a solid block of aluminum. The alert slider has the little contact points up at the top that also connect to the vibration motor. I will show you the contact points on the motherboard here, and this is how those get their signal from the phone itself. There's one screw holding down the two little clasps over these extension ribbon cables. We'll work on those in a second after we remove the battery connection. This disconnects the power from the board, so it's safe to work on. I will unclip the two extension ribbon cables just like little Legos. Same thing with the bottom. You can see that that's really all that this is just an extension ribbon cable from the charging port up to the top motherboard. There's one little piece of tape along the top of the battery. I'm gonna remove that, and then I can just pry the battery out from the phone with a little pull tab on the side. Similar to how the iPhone 4 and 4S batteries were. Very easy, no heat necessary. The biggest disappointment of this phone is that the battery is not red. The OnePlus 1 and the OnePlus 2 phones had a bright red battery, which was fun for repair guys like myself to open up and see something a little bit different. But they went back to being the original boring black batteries. There are 7 screws for the charging port. Remove those, they are Phillips head, and then we're going to remove the wire cable and then 2 ribbon cables with that Lego-like connection, and then the charging port will just pop out from the bottom side of the phone. Here's the charging port. It comes with the headphone jack, the loudspeaker, and the USB Type-C connection. I'll try to find replacement parts for these and link them down in the video description. Here's the tamper-evident screw on the top motherboard and the water damage indicator. We're going to remove the wire cable first from the side, be careful with that connection. Then there's the screen ribbon cable from the side as well. 8 screws hold it down. These screws are all different sizes. Make sure to keep them organized. It is very important you put them back in the same hole they come from. The volume button and power button have little contact points, just like the vibration motor does. Those just rest up against the motherboard here. That's how it receives its signal. So if your phone gets wet and those buttons stop working, it's because there's a little bit of corrosion or something on the contact points. The front-facing camera can just pop out. There's a little bit of tape on the back, so peel that up. This is an 8-megapixel camera. We'll set that off to the side. The rear camera, also unclips from the main board, has the same Lego-like connection. This one here is a 16-megapixel camera, and it does have OIS image stabilizing, so the camera itself compensates for the shaking of your phone while you're holding it. Pretty cool. So this is the screen. It's got the glass layer, the AMOLED layer, and the plastic frame that gives the phone its rigidity. So when you buy a replacement screen, it'll most likely just come with the glass and the AMOLED, and you'll have to pry it out from the plastic frame. But this kills the old screen, so only do it if it's absolutely necessary. I'm not going to transfer mine over because it does sacrifice the screen, and I want to keep on using my OnePlus. The square around the battery is what I imagine helps give this phone its strength. The battery presses up against the sides of the plastic to give it rigidity. Very cool design. Let's reassemble this phone. We'll put back that 8-megapixel front camera and clip it into the board, put the tape down along the back again. You can just transfer the tape from your old camera to your new camera if you're replacing it. The 16-megapixel rear camera gets pressed down into place, and then the whole motherboard can just be pressed down into the frame of the screen. We got the ribbon cable for the screen and the wire cable, and then we have the 8 screws that go in around the outside. Make sure they go into the exact same hole they came out of. Get the charging port set down into place, wire cable, and then the 2 ribbon cables. Bend those around the extension cable and then clip those in. There are 7 screws that hold this in place. Remember, they are different sizes as well, so keep them organized. And then put the boring black colored battery back into the frame. I really hope to see a red battery for the OnePlus 4. Now the 2 pieces of tape along the top aren't super important, but since they were there in the first place, I'll put them back on anyway. And then I'll clip on the extension ribbon cables that connect the charging port to the top motherboard, as well as the little metal bracket. Pinch one side in first and the screw goes in the other side to hold it down. And the last thing you want to do is just stick in the battery connector. That makes sure there's no power going through the phone while you're working on it. Before I put the screen into the back metal panel, I'm going to turn it on and make sure it's working. Looks like everything is fine. You should turn your phone off before inserting it into the back panel, but I'm going to do it anyway. Put the top in first and then pinch down the sides and the bottom. Remember that you are working with a piece of glass here, so don't put too much pressure on it or you'll crack your screen. I'm going to put the bottom two T2 screws into place. That was the tongue twister. And everything is good. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. I did do a behind the scenes snap story on this teardown if you want to check out my Snapchat. I do a lot of behind the scenes stuff on Twitter as well as Instagram. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you around.